I remember when I was pastoring in Gulfport, Mississippi, there was a man that started attending our church, mainly because of the pressure that his new bride was putting on him. And so he started attending, and I went to visit him. He was an absolutely brilliant man, one of the smartest men I have ever met, Mr. Norman Barrett. He was in his mid-70s at the time. And when I went to see him, he had worked, his career was a scientist. And Mr. Barrett said, "Now, Pastor, I want you to know I'm an atheist, or maybe an agnostic, however you define it. But he said, I really don't believe that there is a God. I've always believed in and taught firmly the theory of evolution." And I said, "Well, Mr. Barrett, that certainly is your right." And he was kind and gracious. He wasn't arrogant about it in any way. I said, "I want to just ask you to do one thing. I want to ask you to continue to come to church." Now, if he wanted to keep his new bride, Miss Ethel, he had to, because she put the pressure on him. So Mr. Norm kept coming. After about a year of him attending our church, he walked into my office one morning, and I'll never forget what he said. He said, "Pastor, I've been sitting and listening to you preach and teach the Bible for a year now. I have examined all of the evidence, and I have come to the conclusion there is a God, and I want to know him." And I had the privilege of leading him to Jesus and baptizing him. And when I left almost 12 years ago to come here, Mr. Norm was still faithfully serving the Lord Jesus. But that day, he turned around to walk out of my office, and when he did, he stopped at the door, and he came back in. And he was kind of a little frail man, and he looked at me, and when he did, I saw that there were tears in his eyes. And he said, "Pastor, I have wasted 70 years of my life believing a lie that there is no God." I said, "Mr. Norm, there's nothing I can do about that. It is true, you have wasted 70 years of your life. But the good news, Mr. Norm, is you can enjoy Jesus for an eternity because you have embraced the truth." Friend, this morning in this service, someone may be watching on television. Listen, don't waste another day not believing in God and his gift to you, the Lord Jesus Christ, for the forgiveness of your sins. There is a God, and he wants you to know him.